Even if you tried, you wouldn't understand it. Maybe something's missing inside of you. Just a bit of sugar to that horrid bitter. Maybe you taste different. Hold up, hold up, baby. I can sit beside you while you're going on about your simple life. Nothing left you thinking that maybe you're not different. Guess it never hit you. Our conversation takes two, paying it some interest from time to time. Inside all that greatness and all of your adventures, you're all alone. Hold up, hold up, baby. I can sit beside you while you're going on about your simple life. Nothing left you thinking that maybe you're not different.
Hey, hey guys, and welcome to my Monica bedroom. This room is just filled with stuff. We just didn't know where to put something and we would throw it in here. I'm sure some of you can relate. But we are finally going to tackle this room. We are going to give it a makeover because our baby girl is going to be sleeping in here for a little bit until our two-year-old is old enough to share a room with our five-year-old. We have lots of kiddos. If you are new here, we have four kids, ages 13, 5, 2.5, and almost 6 months. She's 5 months right now. Let's not age her. We have a lot of kids and we have a messy house a lot of the time that we are working to clean up and organize and declutter. We are just a regular family doing our best, and I hope that these types of videos can encourage you guys, motivate you guys to get up and clean up your regular home and make it more functional and nice for your family. So we are going to just work together to get this room in order, figure out where everything needs to go. I am also going to work on our linen closet because that was just driving me crazy. So I'm going to tackle that in today's video, and just the hallway area by our stairs always gets cluttered up and becomes a mess. So we're going to tackle that as well. So I hope that you will clean alongside me or just get some satisfaction from watching this room go from a complete wreck to a nice functional space for our family. If you are new here, I hope that you will subscribe and click the bell to be notified when I post new videos. I'm always putting out content like this, and definitely give this video a thumbs up if you enjoy it. That's just a small way to support my channel.
It was a Thursday night when I first saw you. Those green eyes caught me, yeah, it was crazy. It was a Friday night when I first kissed you. You struck me like lightning, you broke my chains and released me. And days turned into nights on the couch in your apartment. No, I am not the same, everything has changed. Every day, 24/7, you call my name and I will come running. Yeah, every day, 24/7, yeah, every day I will come running, babe. Every day, No, I'm not the same. Everything has changed. Every day, 24/7, you call my name, and I will come running. Yeah, every day, 24/7. Yeah, every day, I will come running.
This room is technically the office in our house. There is no closet in here, so I guess technically it's considered an office, and we have used it as that. My husband also has like his gaming stuff in here, so we will use it for that. And then we are also going to use it as like a fifth bedroom right now, like I said earlier, for baby girl. And I'm gonna put up some cute little princess decals on the wall and just kind of make it feel like her room, even though the big room makeover, the big like girly bedroom makeover, will be when we convert Jack's room into her room. So that will be coming in the future once he's ready. That little guy is ready to share a room with his big brother, but he's not there yet. He needs his own space. So we are blessed enough to be able to convert this room. Right now she's in our bedroom, but eventually she will need her own space. This room has also been a school room, so that's why you see those posters up there. So we have used it for learning, which has been a lot of fun. This little guy, he loves it, just little characters and action figures. He loves to stack them or like put them next to each other. He loves to carry around a bag just filled with random stuff and then dump it out. It's fun. Lots of cleaning going on around here. But we have lived in this home for about 2 years now, and I've still been kind of figuring out how I want to use the space that we have in this house. And of course, our family has grown. We had our baby girl 5 months ago now. So things have changed, and we just kind of grow and change. There are so many things we want to do to this house, so many like renovations we want to do, things to the backyard, things to inside the house. So there will be lots of like more budget-friendly makeovers coming, as well as just even renovations, like bigger budget type stuff eventually. But it's been fun to just figure out how to make this house work best for us. We have homeschooled. We kind of do like a hybrid school for our oldest. And we're just kind of figuring out as a family, like how we want to do schooling, if we want to do homeschooling or not. So we are just kind of going with the flow and utilizing our home as best we can. But yeah. So this is how it goes when you are decluttering and organizing. Things tend to get worse before they get better, but just keep going, keep kind of chipping away, and eventually things will get better, I promise. And cleaning and organizing usually leads to more cleaning and organizing. So while I was tackling the office, I decided to tackle our linen closet as well. So I think that that is a good thing to remember. It's kind of like working out. If you just get the clothes on, like the toughest part is getting your workout clothes on and getting out the door, running, going to the gym, starting the video, whatever. That's the toughest part. But then once you get started, you get that momentum going, you see the results, you start to see results, and it's really motivating. To get motivated, I have found that you need to kind of force yourself to start, and then that is what really motivates you, is starting to see those results. So that is why I tackled the linen closet as well, which is nice. And then do not forget, we are also kind of decorating in a princess way, because it's our first girl after three boys. She will have a full-on princess room soon, but I got a few princess things for her crib that's going in the office. So make sure you watch until the end of the video so you can see how the office/nursery/gaming room turns out. Oh, and I made a mistake in my last video, so I wanted to quickly mention my sponsor from last video, Thrive Market. I absolutely love Thrive Market, you guys, and I put the wrong link in last time, so I'm going to add their link again to this video because you will get a really big discount, and their food is already discounted, so to add a discount code on top of that, you're really going to save a ton on some really high quality good food, whether you want organic, gluten-free, whatever. It's so easy to search on their site. So definitely please check my link down below, get your discount, get yourself some good food. I felt so bad for putting the wrong link, so I'm adding that again to this video, and I hope that you guys will check it out. It really supports my channel when you check out the sponsors that I have. That means so much to me, and I really do share some good, cool stuff. It's really fun to get to share with you guys some fun things that I would shop and love anyway. So Thrive Market is definitely one of those. So please go check out the link down in my description box.
It's a colorful night, got red eyes, but it's all blue. Those colorful eyes, they don't shine like they used to. The city don't want us, babe. We won't survive this place.
The city don't want us. The city don't want it.
And if I would lie and stay, it wouldn't feel the same. I won't lie. No, honestly, it doesn't feel like home. Like home. To fading out underwater. Yeah, are we losing touch? Are we falling? And if I would lie and stay, it wouldn't feel the same. I won't lie. No, honestly, it doesn't feel like home, like home. Home, feel like home. A faded mind, so we stay blind. Oh,
all right, so the linen closet is not like a Pinterest-worthy organized closet at this point, but everything is functional in there. We have our humidifiers that we like to use when the kids are sick. We have candles if we need them. We have our beach towels kind of folded and organized in one spot, our regular towels for my oldest who showers up here, and then like some extra blankets and things, some of my Cricut stuff. So some of the things that were in this room that made more sense to go into that linen closet to be just more easily accessed and organized. So even though it doesn't look super cute, it's actually very functional now and clean and organized in that sense. So please do not be discouraged by the Pinterest-worthy stuff you see or even the things on YouTube and think that's what you have to do if you're going to organize something. You really don't. Just make it functional for yourself. Use things that you already have in your home if you need to, but just make it work for you. It doesn't need to look like this beautiful, you know, picture-worthy space, if that makes sense. So now I'm putting together the little princess crown mobile for Charlie's crib, or at least I was attempting to do it. Henry was wanting to learn about sharks because we found a book in here about sharks, so we were looking those up and reading about them and hugging and kissing. You know, this is my life. I try to do things and I get very distracted by my sweet children, but I love every second of it. It is very, very busy having four kids. They're all in, well, not, they're not all in activities. The two oldest are in activities and, you know, it's busy, but I absolutely love it and feel so, so blessed to have them. But that's me getting frustrated. So call in the husband and he comes and saves the day. He does that for me quite often in my videos when I start to get really frustrated. So I am so, so grateful for him and everything he does for our family. But yeah, we are just gonna make this little tiny space for her, very girly and princessy, and I'm just so excited, but I'm really itching now to do her room someday, someday. Am I the only one that has like two lists full, or I guess a list a mile long of things I want to do to my house? Like there are so many things that I want to do and it's hard to even prioritize them. And then of course I don't have an unlimited budget either. So I'm sure I'm not the only one, but the list of things to do is long, which is fun though. It's inspiring to me. It's something I'm interested in. So, you know, if we were completely done in this house, I'd probably be bored and want to move, but we've got a lot to do, so definitely not bored around here.
We head for the sky, it's all right. Our wings wouldn't fly, it's all right. If we are crashing down again, pieces of love, it's all right. Scattered in mud, it's all right. You're giving me a lie again. And tell me what you want. This time I won't take it to the heart. Cause I know we won't make it out. I've heard it all before. Yeah, tell me what you want. Then be here. I'm the only one. You know that we won't make it out. We've heard it all before. It's all. Sky, it's all right. Our wings wouldn't fly, it's all right. If we are crashing down again, pieces of love, it's all right. Scattered in mud, it's all right. You're giving me a lie again. And tell me what you want. This time I won't take it to the heart. Cause I know we won't make it out. I've heard it all before. Yeah, tell me what you want. Then me in that I'm the only one. We'll be right back.
All right, so now we have little Charlie mean mugging us. Okay, she's giving us a smile now. She is just so cute. She was looking at that camera though, like, what is happening right now? I'm in this crib, which I'm not too sure about, and there's a big camera in my face, but she soon discovered the Belle baby doll and started just going to town on that baby. So she started to have a good time in her crib, and I think she's going to love it in here, hopefully. She has not moved in quite yet. We're going to wait until she's at least 6 months old. She's still in her bassinet in our room, which is recommended that they stay in your room for the first like 6 to 12 months or so. So we'll see when we move her in here, but it feels really good to have this space cleaned up, decluttered. I just kind of bought some like cute little cheesy princess stuff from Target. I'll link it down below for you guys if you're interested, but look at this transformation. All of this junk is cleaned up and the room is organized. We have a little space for her to sleep when she's ready. Of course, this is not going to be her main bedroom. This will go back to being our office once Jack is old enough to share a room with his older brother. But for now, this is a sweet little space for her, and I'm really happy with it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please be sure to give it a thumbs up if you did, and I'll see you next time.